Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 22, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 20th, 1973, in Bombay, India.
The living entity in material nature thus follows the ways of life, enjoying the three modes of nature. This is due to his association with that material nature. Thus he meets with good and evil among various species of life. Purusha. Purusha means enjoyer, the living entity. So that way I have already explained Purusha. Purusha means the enjoyer. And Prakriti means enjoyer. So Purusha Prakriti Stho. The living entity Prakriti Stho means this material world. The living entity, although part and parcel of God, spiritual entity, but he has come to this material world to enjoy. Anyone who is in this material world, his original cause of coming down from the spiritual platform to this material platform means he wanted to enjoy. In the spiritual world, the only enjoyer is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. All others are enjoyed. But here in this material world, everyone is trying to become the Supreme and others to be enjoyed. That everyone is trying to become God. And the last layer of Maya is that one is claiming that I am God. When he tries to become big businessman, big zamindar, big minister, big president, all in the society, big rich man, big all. And when he fails to become all kinds of big, he wants to become one with God. By merging into God, he will be the biggest. That is the philosophy. Basic principle is how to become big. Otherwise, because unless I become very big, I cannot enjoy. So, what is the field of this enjoying activities? This body that we have discussed. Khetra khetra jnana. Idam shariram khetram iti avidhiya. This body is the field of activities. So Purusha, the living entity, has been entrapped by this material energy. That is called Purusha Prakritistho. He is not required to stay in this material world, but he has decided to enjoy this material world. Therefore he is here. But he can give up. That is called liberty. That is called salvation. He can give up. Mukti. Mukti means, that is also described in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Hitya annatha rupam sarupena avasthiti. That is called mukti. Mukti hitva annatha rupam. Here every living entity is situated annatharupam. Annatharupam means otherwise, which is not his nature. His nature is to serve, but he is staying here not as servant, but as master. Purusha prakritistha hi bhunte. Bhunte means enjoys. Prakriti jnana guna. Prakriti jnana, he is He has come here to enjoy, but he is enjoying not the prakriti, but prakriti janatma, but the qualities of the prakriti. There are three qualities of the prakriti: goodness, passion and ignorance. Prakriti jan guna. These are products of material world. It is therefore described in another place. Deja Gunamai Gunamai Mamo Maya Durataya. This illusory energy is, there are three qualities. Qualitative. Some of them, therefore we find different types of species of life. Every living entity has associated with a particular type of guna. There are three gunas, namely goodness, passion and ignorance. And if you mix them up, then it becomes 9. 3 into 3 = 9. And again if you mix up 9 into 9, then it becomes 81. Therefore there are 8,400,000 species of life. Jalajanavalakhanisthavalalakhaninsati. 900,000 species in the water. Similarly, birds, bees, trees, insects, animals. Then we come to the human form of life. These different types of bodies are meant for enjoying in a different spirit. Everyone is trying to enjoy. But he is enjoying, he is not enjoying the prakriti, but he is enjoying the association of the guru. Purusha prakriti so he bhumte prakriti jana guna. Karanam guna samas. So every living entity is suffering or enjoying. There is no enjoyment, everyone is suffering. But he, that is called Maya, he is suffering but he takes it as enjoying. In the hope, the peace, he is eating stew, but he is thinking that he is enjoying. He is enjoying. He enjoys a certain type of food according to his quality. Nowadays, because people are becoming more and more in the modes of darkness, they are eating so many abominable things. And prakriti also, minimizing the supply of sattvic food. Just like nowadays it has become scarcity of grains, of meat, of sugar, it is practical experience. Because people are becoming more and more in the modes of ignorance, therefore the foodstuff, these foodstuffs are in the modes of goodness. Just like Krishna wants, patram pushpam phalam tuyam juvi bhakta prajitsit. Krishna does not say, give me meat and drinking wine. Krishna can eat everything. He is omnipotent. But he does not say that give me anything and everything. No. He specifically mentions, patram pushpam phalam tuyam juvi bhakta prajitsit. These things are the foodstuff in goodness. Rice, dal, wheat, that means grains, then sugar, fruits, vegetables, milk products, these foods are in the goodness. And similarly, there are foods, very chilly, very hot, these are in the passion. And similarly, in ignorance also, there are many foods, stale food. Means these are in the ignorance. So our business is this human form of life to get out of this cycle of birth and death and wandering in different species of life. This is the mission of human life. Human life advanced consciousness. It is meant for getting out of this cycle of birth and death and wandering in different species of life. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, Hey Rupe Brahmanna Bhavite Kono Bhagavan Ji, Guru Krishna Kripaya Paya Bhakti Rata Ji. In this way, the living entities,
Purusha,
Pratishtha, within this material world, he is one night in different species of life, in different planets. But the disease is birth and death. Even if you take birth in the Brahma Loka, Krishna says, Nābhrahma bhūna lokān punarāvartinoti. Even if you promote it to the Brahma Loka, the highest planet, there is also death. You cannot avoid janma mrityu jarāpyādi dukkha dosānu darsanam. That is real knowledge. That I don't want to die, but I am forced to die. I don't want to become old man, but I am forced to become old man. I don't want any disease, but disease is forced upon me. So these are the real problems. So Krishna says that you may get a long duration of life, very comfortable life in higher planetary system. Just like people are engaged in doing pious activities. The result of pious activities is that you get your birth in a very good family, in a rich family, you get beauty, you become educated. Janma Shabda Sutta Sri. Janma means birth, high class birth. And Oishabda means opulence, riches. And Sutta means education. And Sri means beauty. So by pious activities, you can get all these things. And impious activities, the opposite number. So that family, abominable, pāpajūna, lower grade family, not very beautiful, not educated, suffering in so many ways. So either you get this life or that life, the janma-mrityu jarāpyādi is there. It is not that because you have got very beautiful body, and born in very high-class family and highly educated, you will avoid janma-mrityu jarāpyādi. That is not possible. The real problem is janma-mrityu jarāpyādi.
The kāraṇam guṇa-saṅgayasya
sadasādhyani, high-class life, and asādhyani, pāpajūni. So, why one is born in lower-grade family? Why one is born in high grade family? Karanam guna sangasya. The cause is as he has associated with different types of world. Unfortunately, this science that there is birth after death and there is actually we are experiencing a sin, but they do not inquire. They think that one can improve. That is not possible, unless he changes the quality. He cannot improve. That is not possible. They do not know it. They are falsely trying to improve the position. Nobody is trying to become poor. Everyone is trying to become rich. But it is not possible, because he has got a particular type of body. And that body is already destined, and he has to achieve happiness or suffer distresses according to the body. Therefore, Śāstra says, tasyai vati to pragati to kovila, nanam bhateja bhamakāmu varli. He should try for that thing which he did not receive in your past life. Past life by our past activities or impious activities, we have got a type, different type of body. Here or in higher planetary system, that's all right. But that is not solution of my problem. The real problem is janma-mrityu jarāpyādi. So we should save time and utilize it how to get out of this janma-mrityu jarāpyādi. That is the whole Vedic civilization. Therefore, it is said, tasyai vaheta prajati kovila. If you are intelligent, then you should engage your life. How to get out of this cycle of birth and death? Tapodibvam putraka jinasuddhita sattha. We have to purify our existence so that we can revive our original position of eternal life, blissful life, full of knowledge. That is our requirement. The modern civilization They have no such information. Everyone is trying to improve his condition according to the quality, but that is not improvement. Real improvement is how to get out of this cycle of birth and death. That is real improvement. Janu Nitya Jarabhya, Dukkha Dosha Anjana. Thank you very much.